Having a conflict up there. So we do a lot of thinking about this type of stuff, and I try to, as much as possible, my job for the last 25 years in leadership development is to try to build a model. And so this model, a lot of our models come from pro hockey and hockey. Now just thinking, because I've seen a lot of conflict, the team that we were fortunate in 86 to win a cup, that team in February was pretty much a dysfunctional team. Right? 100 days later, you know, we're one of the, I guess, the top team in the league. So you see that stuff. I guess give you a thought on conflict. John Gottman has got some great stuff out of Seattle and a PhD out there. He's actually a marriage guy. And he says conflict's not the issue. Isn't that exciting? Everybody happy about that? Right? He said couples don't get divorced over conflict. They get divorced over contempt. So when conflict turns into contempt, I had to Google that word, right? We're done. So what we've sort of thought about is when we're in conflict, if you can try to turn it towards community, right? As these guys are talking about, deal with it, get it out, you know, have a good community, instead of contempt on the other side, you get a chance. And we were thinking two ideas for you, just because I want to be practical. If we move towards contempt, Gottman says we're turning away. Isn't that good? We're turning away from each other. We move towards community, we're turning towards. Isn't that good? It's so simple. So here's your analogy you'll never forget. Numbers, not, right? Don't go to numbers, go to logos. Simple. We're turning towards each other, so you're looking at a logo, you're not looking at a number, you're not talking about somebody. And if you can do that with your parent group, you got a great, great season.
What, in your experience, do you think is the best and worst way to deliver good and bad news to a player?
Well, I guess